After getting that first ROV dive done, we moved up to our main target area, which was the inside corner high of the Mid-Atlantic Ridge and the Cane Fracture Zone, looking for plume signals. We didn't find any. We looked extensively, and if there was any kind of venting that was at all similar to the Lost City hydrothermal field, we would have seen that in the water. Just having the mantle rocks exposed on an oceanic core complex reacting with seawater may not be enough to produce the level of heat you need to get that type of system. But we did end up finding instead a more mid-ocean ridge type, high temperature hydrothermal system where nobody had looked before. It's a really large vent field. There are metal sulfides, two separate areas of high temperature venting, both with large chimneys, shrimp, vent fish, gastropods, a lot of small fauna that when you zoom in with the camera, you can see. That's an interesting and important discovery. And it says something about how the faults in this area are tapping the heat source, the volcanic heat source from the mid-ocean ridge axis. There's an international discussion about seafloor mining going on. The International Seabed Authority makes the decisions on what can happen. And I think they need much better data on what's out here. Where are the mineral deposits? How do they relate to the biological communities that are living on them? What would be the result if you took out one of those sites? What about the inactive sites? Is it safe to go and mine these inactive hydrothermal sites? The details of what the biological communities are that are living at that site will fit into the model of how animals disperse and move from site to site along the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, and just help modeling the entire system and understand how it works. It's challenging to find this Lost City type of venting or serpentinization driven venting. So I'm a little disappointed in not finding that, but I'm not at all disappointed in how the work has gone, because this is exploration and you can't count on finding something that you're looking for necessarily, but we know that we're gathering other information that's going to be valuable in just understanding the geology of this type of environment. I think we're still on track to produce probably the best high-resolution map of a core complex that has been done. We're getting way more information about what's in the water column than anyone has tried to get before. I'd say things are going really well.